The session today is on an analyst approach to personal finance and personal investments. So right now we're trying to get everybody in the session to indicate, you know, what your current experience is as regards using Excel for analyzing or tracking your personal finance or investments. So if you check the chat box, I have put the link that you can get straight to this poll, and I'm going to repost it anyway. And if you see the screen too, you will see that you can go to menti.com and enter the code 8072869, and you can go to the link that I've just pasted in the chat box. You know, that one, you don't need to type anything, you just tap it, and then instantly you're going to be taken to. And so I'm hoping to see like two or three answers. You know, use the Excel for tracking your investments and finance. Session is today. Okay, so great, everybody, awesome. All the people who are filled say yes. So that's a nice. That means I won't be talking. I'm talking to someone who has not used Excel for their personal finance. All right, so we jump off this then, and I think to personally for me, what I've been Excel, and like I told you, I now use Google Sheets more. I'll tell you why. Similar with the, I'm sure. That maybe with some extra being able to achieve it in Excel. So, number one, that when it comes to investments, we all try to have like a portfolio. So let me zoom my screen. For some weird reason, the Zoom is refusing to work. Okay, now it's working. So all of the zooming I've been doing is just now popping up. Okay, so these are the most people when they are investing, right? They like, I know most Nigerians. That's a very, very big thing to be in. Right, so most Nigerians, they invest in real estate. So most Nigerians invest in real estate, and also we have to recognize that it's not useful to put all your money just there idle in the bank. So again, most Nigerians they do some kind of money market, you know, or fixed income. Okay. Around the short term, the money markets won. So anyway, so these are things that we invest in. Then some people that have some boldness. So because again, that's what I've noticed in the groups I'm in the communities I've been part of. Someone's giving me a feedback. Alexander says my network seems to be fluctuating. Is it true? Is it like that for everybody? I have to.
Yes.
Okay. So it's actually not stable.
Device is a fluctuation.
Oh, okay. I'm going to switch there. Okay. There. Give me. I'm going to do a switch right now. Since you see my screen on this one, I'm going to unmute myself. Okay. Right. So I'm going to do a network switch, depending when I I'm going to just turn this one on. Okay, is this better? So I'm going to try to disconnect. I use two networks anyway, and it's because I am suspecting something like this might come up. That's why I decided to use two networks. So, okay, trying to switch network. Let's see. Okay, I'm going to turn off this one. Turn off. Turn on this one. Turn on my speaker. So what about now? Is it better now?
It's better now.
Oh, all right. Thank you for letting me know on time. Okay, thank you very much. So this is even helpful. So now I know which network to be on for the remainder of the sessions. So apologies for that. Thank you, Alexander, for quickly letting me to know. So I will just quickly just say that I think you see my screen. Do you see my screen? Are you able to see my? Okay, great. So I was mentioning that kind of things that I'm saying that most Nigerians invest in real estate, in money market / fixed income. So when you fix your money, the light went off, the electricity went off. So that's why it's a bit dark. When the hotel turns it back on, you see my face clearer. But then it does not affect my presentation anyway. So we invest in fixed income and also in stocks. So I was saying that usually it's the people who are bold amongst us who go for stocks. Unfortunately, now the fixed income is now so very bad that that people are now beginning to move back into stocks, right? So how do you track all of this? Then in addition, for me, I also do...
Hello.
I think we lost
see, you. Okay. I'm back now, right?
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Apologies. That's what happens when you are using MTN and the rest. And so... then also to do it. What about if I can you hear me clearly if I'm using? This for mic. So I have this for mic. Is this one clear? Hello?
Hello.
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 Are you able to hear me?
Yes, Tom.
Hello, can you hear me clearly?
Now I hear you.
Are you? Wow. Okay, it's gone. Okay. So what I'm doing now is moving more to this one for speaker. So I'm just going to, but I'm not able to hear you. That's the
funny thing now. Can somebody just say something? Well, yeah.
Something.
Okay. But do you all hear me louder?
Yeah, Mike, you can hear me louder. We can hear, but it's breaking. It comes in an interval, so we lose a lot of information.
Maybe I'm going to switch. Okay. I'm going to switch. I'm connecting two devices on the network. Maybe that also too is affecting. Let's see if I do a switch to just one device. So I'm going to disconnect from this one. Disconnect. Let me just grab my links. So I'm going to quickly grab my links. I'm going to email myself the links so that I can pick up easily from the next one. Links. Sorry for the glitches today. I'm going to just grab all the links I need. And then I also need a particular file. So I'm going to just close the file here so I can pick it up on the other. Up on the other PC. For finance investments. So I'm just going to disconnect this one. I'm going to say disconnect.
Okay,
let me disconnect this one completely.
Please do not leave us any more glitches. Maybe I'll turn off my video. That will also turn off my video. Okay, good. I'm going to just turn off all the documents except. So now that I've reduced devices on the net, maybe I'll get a better experience. But are you able to give me like
the breaks are not stopping in this particular one
lap right now? Is this smooth now? All right, so we carry on from there.
It's those annoying breaks that were present before.
Loud and clear, and it's not having those annoying. Can somebody help me with the confirmation? Guys. Telling me the bed.
Okay, so are we able to hear me clearly on this one?
So apologies again. Are you able to hear me clearly and no more echoes, right? Not to need to race against time. So if you see on my screen, you should be able to see where I stopped the other time. Okay. And so I was mentioning that the different things that we as Nigerians, we try to invest in, or we typically invest in, these are those list of items, securities, classes that I noticed that Nigerians invest in. And then I'm going to show you how I use Google Sheets, which, as I mentioned, is also safe. So how I use Google Sheets, and which is possible to do with Excel, but I'll mention why there's a slight advantage to Google Sheets. So now, what I do is I have a plan of what I want. So a plan is Zoom. Okay, great. I have a plan that these are the target allocation as regards the different things I invest in. So I invest in real estate, in Nigerian stocks, cryptocurrency, US stocks. You will notice that there's one category here that I do not have. So I try not to put my money in money market, partly because actually money market is in the developed countries. Money market is where you put your money short term. You know, you park your money pending when you know what you want to, pending when you are certain of what you want to do with it, or waiting to enter at an opportune time. So for instance, you want to buy a property, right? So you just move the money you will use for the property into the money market, and then you will start shopping for the property. And then once so maybe you took the money out of your stocks, or you took it out of from somewhere else. Maybe you sold some Bitcoin, or you sold some shares, or you sold some investment that you had, and then you, is that money you want to use to buy, you know, that thing? Or it could even be you want to buy a personal effect, you want to buy a car. It's not when you get to the distribute to the dealer that you are not going to start thinking of where you will withdraw the money from. So most of the time you will have budgeted that, okay, I'm going to spend like $3 million on this, on a car, and then you take the money out. Or maybe you normally you have somewhere, maybe you take part of it out, and you know your salary is going to come at the end of the month. You're going to maybe move 800K from that one to and have. The point is that I started my finance career with the technical background, understanding that money market is not really meant for long term. It's not really meant for somewhere to keep your money for the long term. It's usually for to park your money till you use it for what you want to use it for in some immediate term. So that knowledge kind of has screwed me in the Nigerian market, because in Nigeria, things are kind of not the normal. You know, imagine money market getting you 18%, 20%. That was what it was doing 2 years ago. And people who stayed there made more money than those of us who put our money in something else, well, in stocks or so. It's a kind of valid class for people in Nigeria, but for me, I have always kept moving with that mindset. So I never really kept any money that I'm not planning to use in the immediate term, in the next 1 to 6 months. I never really put them in money markets. So that's why I don't have money market. And then if you notice, what I've done is I said that I'm going to do US stocks 20%, cryptocurrencies 20%. Before, cryptocurrencies were 10% for me. But when this problem started in Nigeria, I hope you still all hear me loud and clear now. I hope there are no more issues with my voice and all. Can somebody help me confirm so that I don't just keep assuming? you could confirm that. Okay, so I guess we've found a lasting solution then. Sorry that you won't see my face because I think maybe that one too was eating into the bandwidth. So again, I'm trying to walk you through my own real life approach, you know. So it's not really to help you make this, it's to create a mindset and frame. Doing them are not difficult because they are just normal arithmetic formulas, right? So I said I was going to do 20% US stocks. I've always been on that kind of target for US stocks. Cryptocurrency is now 20 before 10. Now 20 because of what I'm experiencing in Nigeria with the whole issue of capital control, you know, government, CBN suddenly saying that if you deposit dollars in your dorm account, you know, there are some kind of funny restrictions to how you can access it. And then there was at some point, there were some rumors that they will keep adding more to the restrictions. So I decided that, well, instead of having any dollar fund, you know, being directly in the system as a dorm account, let me put them in a stable coin, let me put them in crypto. So that was why I moved it up from 10% to 20%. Though right now, I kind of will be careful if I want to buy into any crypto. I normally just do three types of crypto. I do Bitcoin, I do Ethereum. I've been in the crypto space since 2015. I paid one of my instrumental school salaries with Bitcoin. So for me, it's not on a speculative level. It's based on touching the, you know, dipping my toe in it gradually till I started having confidence and being able to put in what I understand, you know, what I'm comfortable with, and I buy only the things that I understand. So you won't see me buy any fancy Bitcoin Cash. You won't see me buy things that I take the approach I take to stocks to it anyway. Then I think I have Ripple too. So these are the four that I've been buying steadily for the last 2 years. I've been buying Bitcoin. I bought it in 2015 before, but that was just to test it. But in the last 2 years or 1.5 years, I've been steadily buying, and I sell too. I take profits and then I go back in, and I've been really fortunate. I've never really lost any money. My analysis has always played right. But I'm just trying to let you understand that it shouldn't just be something you do based on the fact that someone says he's doing it. For me, my journey to being in cryptocurrency is over that 5 year span of me using it to pay for my school fees and then buying it, trying to understand it, you know, doing courses on it, reading up on it, understanding the thing behind it, understanding the potential around it, trying to just get a very good grasp of it so that whatever I'm doing, I don't lose my sleep, you know. I don't, no matter what happens, it goes up, it goes down. I know, I have a very clear knowledge of what I've done as regards investing in it. So then Nigerian stocks used to be, I think, 40% or was it 30%? So I took part of the allocation to that to move to crypto. So, and the reason why I reduced my Nigerian stocks is, like I told you, it's still the same thing. I wanted to increase the crypto and I could not decrease my US stocks. So I decided it should be the Nigerian stocks. The real estate is doing fine and it's not, though it's overweight currently, I have more than my target on it. But that's just because I don't have so much money. And so the only property that was meaningful to buy was actually very relatively expensive for me, and I had to sell some stocks to buy it. And so that's why over time, as I keep investing more and more, all these other ones will go up, and gradually this one's proportion will reduce. So now you see that this is my own portfolio investment, my own investment portfolio. It's on Excel. This is a kind of Excel anyway, right? So every day, whether on my phone, because I can access this also too on my phone, all I just do is I open it and I see what my position is. I see all there is about my investment strategy, my personal investment, you know, also personal finance, but now the investment side of it. And you know what? These things are automatically calculated. We all understand that allocation means how much you have in that part, the current value. So the current value of my US stocks divided by my total, you know, value, right? And you know what? Even these US stocks, is also automatically computed. So this is automatically picking my US stocks in dollars and multiplying by the current exchange rate. And you know what? This current exchange rate is live. It's picking directly the parallel market exchange rate. So it changes every day. I don't have to manually come here to type in the exchange rate. So this, if you see, there's a formula behind it. I don't want to dwell too much. But then, if it were, this thing is happening. Going to switch. Okay. Apologies. I don't know if I'm back. Am I back? Sorry. I noticed the thing went off again. But are you able to see my screen again? So what I've done is I have three internets. I've switched to the third one. I'm praying this one stays steady. It's just that unfortunately, this third one doesn't have as much gigabyte, but if it's steady, I'll just quickly load it with another. But please, are you able to, can someone just verify? Can you verify if you still hear me? Can somebody unmute and just say something if you should like go on?
Are we?
Sorry, apologies again for all of that. I'm in a hotel, as usual now. The internet is crappy, and then my own phone internet now misbehaving too. So I was mentioning that what makes this thing really special is that it's all kind of automated. The only thing that is not automated here is the real estate, because there's nowhere that I can pick the real estate price. In fact, I don't really know what the value is until I call the estate I bought the property in and I ask them what's the current value. So, but every other thing, the good thing is that one too doesn't fluctuate that much. So maybe once in 4 months or once in 6 months, I update the real estate. But you see, all of these ones, the US stocks, the cryptocurrency, the Nigerian stocks, all these are three asset types. These ones that change every day, they are automatically, you know, computed here. So I was mentioning that the exchange rate you see here is the exchange rate that is coming directly from the parallel market. So it's currently 475. When the thing was 500, it reflects here. You know, so I don't have to be the one manually coming here to update the exchange rate. And then it's all of that computes. And then for the cryptocurrency, similar to, there's a formula, if you look at it here, that picks the dollar value and then multiplies it by the exchange rate. And you know what? This one too is coming from a dedicated sheet. So I'm going to show you those sheets one after the other anyway. And then there's in Nigerian stocks. And this one too is coming from a dedicated sheet. You will notice that I added a particular amount anyway. So this one is the money that I put in a mutual fund. Unfortunately, the mutual fund does not give me somewhere to pick the value from. But you see, all my Nigerian stocks, those ones are coming from a Nigerian stocks sheet. And I will show you how every day the market closes, the value automatically computes in this my Nigerian stock sheet. And then for the real estate, what I've done is I created a separate sheet for it. So now this is a very straightforward that I know people do themselves. You just take your asset by classes, you type in the value, in our case in dollars, the value in Naira. I calculate the percentage allocation. Then if you have a target allocation, you write it there. Then you check, is there a variance? Is there somewhere you're overweight? Is there somewhere you're underweight? So it's always good that you have an investment strategy. You know, it's important that you have an investment strategy. What is an investment strategy? A strategy that is something on the minimal, at least like this, where you say, I'm going to be X percent in this, X percent in that. Instead of you just waking up tomorrow and you're like, oh, stock market is going up, go grab all of your money and dump in there. No. You even need to have an emergency fund. So like for me, I have a separate one that is an emergency fund. you know, somewhere you can go get money for emergencies without having to sell your shares. So, and I move on. If you have any questions, you can always unmute yourself and ask. And you can also type in the chat box. I am monitoring the chat box on a separate screen. So now, if you look at my screen here, this is where I have the sheet for the US stocks. So these are the US stocks that I own, right? Well, up until here. So this is a gold future. So I've always believed that gold is going to go up. So it didn't go up as much as the US companies, the equities went up. But as you can see, I have most of what I bought at $14.71 and current price is $17.52. So I've made some, how many percent gain now? This is over 10%. It's 19, almost 20% gain. Okay, it's not much. I also, this year, I bought into oil. So this one, I made some mistakes at first, but at least I think I'm evened out. So when the coronavirus hit and all this lockdown happened, you know, oil really tanked. You know, when the airspace were closed, countries were no longer letting people fly in, fly out. So oil really tanked and I bought in. And you see $5.48, and then my current price is $8.05, at least for this ETF that I bought in through, right? So that's like 46.9%. But the key thing is, all I have to do is I put the date I bought those things, I put the price that I bought them at. So that's one you have to put yourself. You know, you're not going to use a formula. If you use a formula to capture the price, it will be changing. It will be as if you are capturing the current price. The current price that I'm using a formula. So if you see it, there's a formula. That's why I'm using Google Sheet, actually. So Google Sheet. Okay, so someone is asking me a question. I'm going to answer the question. You say, what platform or broker do I use Nigerian stocks? Is that the same place you fetch the data from, or you pass this data manually? So I use Meristem and I use ARM. I also have an account with Trove, but the one I use actively for all my stocks, because the disadvantage of using multiple brokers is for dividends, you will do multiple stress. So you will have to process dividend mandate for every broker that you are using for Nigerian stocks. Unfortunately, that's the reality. So before, I used to use mixture of ARM and Meristem, but when I saw the problem with e-dividend mandate, I had to sell all my shares on ARM and then put all the money in Meristem so that I have only one broker. Then I can just run the whole dividend stress with just that broker. That is directly into my. What's the other question? Is that the place I fetch data from? No. I don't. They don't even let me connect. So there, I have to log in to see anything. Sometimes even logging in can be problematic. So no, I don't get the data from them. So where do I get my data from? For the Nigerian stocks, it's like an API. So you see these US stocks, I use Google Finance. Google Finance allows you to get the price of any company trading on the US exchange. So that one, very straightforward. All you just do is type Google Finance. And if you are lost, you can always Google for step. You know, you can read the help about that formula. So it's not a difficult thing to use, but for US stocks. For Nigerian stocks, I will tell you what I do when I get on that particular sheet. So what I have done is I list all the companies that I have shares in, okay? And then the cryptocurrency too, because the same formula works. It's still the same Google Finance that I'm using. So that's why I decided, well, instead of doing two separate sheets, why not just put all my dollar holdings, my US stocks and my crypto on the same sheet, okay? So that's what I have done. And then Nike, actually the broker I use gave me some Nike gifts. I don't know what they were doing that period. So they gave me some Nike shares as a bonus, as a gift, I don't know, like promo. And I saw it keep going on. I'm like, okay, this Nike makes sense. So, and so I just bought some more, and but it's very little. I just, one day I just said, let me put something extra. And it has really done amazingly well anyway. So I also have shares before, you know, for a long time I was in the treasury bond when I felt the stock market was going to crash. But when I know that oil was going to go up, I moved all my shares from the treasury, US treasury, to oil. So that's why this one is really low now. So I moved them to oil. And this one is the transportation sector. So again, to when the coronavirus hits, you know, I had this strong belief that the transport, because again, our transportation sector was affected, you know, shipping, airline, truck, you know, rail. So what I did was I looked for an ETF, a basket of companies, a basket of, that's what ETF mean anyway, like a basket of shares that are majorly in that transportation industry. And then I bought, and see, it has gone up 57% in half a year, you know, in March, when December, okay, like in 9 months anyway. So that means my bet, that's the thing I found about US stocks. You can think logically about it, and your logic will play out. You know, you could, all the knowledge we know, you know, all the readings, the finance knowledge, they kind of, they work. You know, it looks like, it's not a perfect market, an efficient market, but the efficiency is a lot better than our own Nigerian one. So I've always had more success with the US stocks. Though I've not made so much money as I see other people make, and that's because for me, I kept feeling a lot of companies are overvalued, and they keep getting more overvalued. But what I know is I can sleep well, think that I won't make a loss, and I know that if the market crashes, you know, it won't be really bad. Like, I'm not afraid when someone predicts the market will crash. But some people, when they read any prediction of the market crashing, they begin to, you know, feel uneasy, because they know that the companies they are buying, they don't really understand the logic behind what they bought. So for me, that's that portion to investment of you understanding what you are doing. So that way, investment does not become like something that will increase your blood pressure anymore. You know, you might not be making the killer profits you see some other people make, but what you are making is still better than if you had not been in it. And you will have peace of mind that you would have lost if you had started doing things just haphazardly. And then, like I mentioned, I also do cryptocurrency. So these are the cryptos I bought. And so what I'm going to do is I will share with you, I have a free to access. As you know, I can't give you my own before you go and change the figures in my own personal one. But I have one that is not personal that you can use. So I'm going to post it in the chat box. So you too can use it to create, to some extent, your own. Is it this one? No, it's not this one. It's not this one. Let me look for, I think it's going to be just stocks, this one. Okay, this one. So I'm going to dump this right now in the chat box. So that way you can also, you can try to create your own. So you can create yours, follow without, you know, having to do the formulas, following these templates, these free to use templates. So you don't have to worry about formulas anymore, you know. So if you use this one, most of all, what I'm demonstrating, you will be able to do for your own too. You know, unfortunately, I can't give you this particular one because this one has my own investment in them. If you go and change something there, it will affect my tracking. So you will notice that even in the template I've shared with you, all the formulas are there. Every day as the prices change, this calculates my nominal profit and loss. You know, I will have, if I had not sold the majority of my Bitcoin, so in October, I traveled and I needed to take some money to cover some expenses. So I sold my Bitcoin. I sold like a significant chunk of my Bitcoin. It's very painful because if I had not, you know, this is the kind of gain I'll be experiencing now. I'll be experiencing 86.7, you know, because I bought that particular Bitcoin around here. It was still a gain when I bought it, but when I sold, I didn't make so much gain if I kept it. But that's life anyway. It's like that for everybody. So it calculates the nominal gain. It calculates the return in percentage. So which one is this that is 167? That's Ethereum. Ethereum has been on a tier two. I've made it really good money from Ethereum. But that's the nature of Bitcoin. It's volatile. All of it can go down, you know, in next month. So it's not the kind of investment that you see that is going up and you quickly go and take your money from somewhere else and pump into it. No, that's what the target allocation allows you to be disciplined about. Then this one calculates on an annualized way, you know. So on a yearly way, you know, taking a whole year, what is your annual return? So you find out that, like this one, that my nominal return is 19.10%. But when you look at it, it's over 2 years, you know, last year, that's 1% of this year. So that's why when you look at it on a 1 year basis, it's actually like 10%. And then there's another one that was 46%. But when I look at it on a 1 year basis, it's actually 63% because all those gains I made are in less than 1 year between March and now. So all those formulas are already there, you know. And for those of us that are more technical, techie, you might want to check out, okay, what is the price to earning ratio? You know, what is the investment beta? What is the volatility? You know, volatility means how does it go up and down, you know, crazily or just manageably. Then I have the number of shares, and then this calculates the actual value. Then this calculates as at the entirety of all my US holding, what is the percentage allocation. So obviously you can see that most of my money are in gold and oil. Okay, so, and those things don't, they are like a sure, I'm very, very certain of them. You know, gold, I just have this very strong certainty that gold will go up because dollar is weakening. You know, that's my explanation, you know. The timing can be, I might never be able to predict the time, but just something I know, and between last year and now, it's really been going up. And then the same thing too with oil. Even the oil companies agree that oil will go back up. Once the airlines resume fully, once the shipping lines resume fully, you know, once a whole lot of, you know, this lockdown hits, so there'll be more demand and it's going to go up. Well, that's what all the signals point to. So that's why I'm heavily in quotes, you know, and the other ones are just like my entire dollar investment. And these ones are just for those who are more on the technical analysis side. So they get to see what's the move. And those who are more academically inclined can be like, what's the Trainor ratio, the Jensen's alpha. These are all measures of portfolio efficiency. You know, how is your portfolio really, really doing versus, you know, if just randomly stuff. So I mean, this is possible. I've given you the link. You can do your own. You don't have to type out the formulas. All what you just in that link I shared, you just put in your own company. Those that are not yours. You say, okay, I don't have any shares in this company. I press delete on it. I don't want to press it because it affects the company. And then you put the, you pick the company that you have investment in. So you could be like, okay, these are the companies. You see, it has the open list of all the companies. So just, if you bought a share in a company, you know the ticker, it's just normal. There's no way you buy a share in a company and you don't know their ticker. That's almost impossible. You just put the ticker in and bring out all of this. The only thing, you see all the things I put in yellow are the things that you are supposed to modify. You just put in the day that you bought those shares. You put in the price, you put them out. Better to put the price plus the transaction cost because you pay some trading fees, you know? So it's better you put it that way, you'll be able to actually see your true profits because those things had your cost, you know, just like you bought a share $10 per share, but if you pay a fee of $1, if you bought one share, that one share is $11, no longer $10, because that fee is a cost, that the profits that you make, you have to be more than that cost plus the grab buy. So how you do that, you see all these green ones, they will calculate themselves, you know, automatically. So that's why I say Excel can be really amazing, or in this case Google Sheet can be amazing to help you automate some of all these, your personal finance and investment activities. Okay, so then for the Nigerian stocks, this is the one that I'm most proud of because it took me a lot of time to figure this one out. Mr. Moses is asking really difficult questions. So you're asking, does this adjust for inflation? Unfortunately, no. No, it does not. I have another tool that allows you to capture inflation. Maybe I'll mention it. I'll try to mention it. The tool will only show you inflation. Let me just quickly, if you go to Excel Online, so if you type Excel Online in your browser, you know, and you click on the Excel Online link, you will see it's the first thing that will come up. So it's a free tool. So Excel Online is free. That's why I'm mentioning Excel Online. So when you go there, and then, you know, when you, it will come up to something like this, click on a new workbook. So when you click on a new workbook, right, when it comes up, when it opens up, right, there is a part of it that I want you to go to. So I want you to go to, you see under insert, you will see add-ins, right? I'm trying to be a bit slow now because I know that not all of you are able to follow me, but just know that maybe I'll type it in the search box, in the chat box, so that you can get the, you know. So go to Excel Online. So I'm typing it in the chat box, you know, via Google search. So when you go there via Google search, okay, now create a new Excel. Fine. So like I have done now. So then I go to insert menu. So go to insert menu. Now you will see add-ins there. So if you go to add-ins, so click on add-ins on the extreme right. Okay. So when you click on add-ins, you won't see what I'm seeing as it is here, because these are my add-ins. For you, you under my add-ins will be blank for you. What you will have to do is you go to store. So click on store. You might have to copy paste these things that I'm writing as steps. Then in the search box, type Nigeria. So if you type Nigeria in the search box, Okay, now this will come up. So just, you know, click on add beside the Nigerian market data. So if you do this, so I'm going to click on add. It will tell you, do you want to continue? So once you do that, you will instantly see that it has added that adding. So you will see it, you know, at the extreme end of your Excel, right? So I'm going to click on that Nigerian market data. So it has a bunch of tools. In fact, you can use it also for tracking stock. You know, if you want to see what's the stock price, the stock market at the last traded day, you know, it will bring all those information out. What I clicked should have come up by now. Then the other thing I wanted to point out is the inflation that you mentioned. If I come here and I click inflation, right, it's going to bring out the inflation figures. Something is weird is happening. Normally it should have come out by now. Let me just check on mine. But for you, you should see something happening. I'm guessing maybe it will be internet again that is affecting mine.
Yeah, so I think it's the internet.
Okay. Oh, see now, everything I've been clicking are just coming out right now. So you're right, it's definitely the internet. So I was about to verify if something was broken. Unfortunately, the inflation has covered the. So this is will have been inflation. You know, you will see those inflation figures. So this becomes like a one-stop tool for you to access all those macroeconomic and all those. In fact, I use it to keep track of our forex reserve. You know, I use it to keep track of exchange rate. So what is the parallel market exchange rate? You know, what is the official market? So I don't think anybody, any regular person has access to that for day-to-day things. Then I keep a lot, even what our GDP growth rate. So I that's why I decided to open it out to also to you, because I noticed that we are unfortunate in Nigeria that most of the tools that exist don't come to Nigeria. You will get this request for free. easily have a problem. When it comes to Nigeria, it's as if you are looking for something really secret. Okay, so Mr. Moses, that is the only thing I can say that, okay, you can use that to get what the inflation rates are, but you will now be the one that will have to do the mathematics to factor it back into, you know, your investment return. So back to walking you through how me have been able to use Excel to automate the analysis of my investment portfolio. So you will notice that all of these, and I've given you the template, so you don't have to worry about the formulas. You just have to understand the concept that this is possible. And once you understand that this is possible, that is all that you need. It's just for you to be filling anywhere you see the yellow ones, those are the ones you fill. So like for Nigerian stocks, you pick which company, you know, type the company name, what date you bought the shares, how much it was per share. Then this one will automatically come out. So like for me now, on my own investment stuff, these are the Nigerian shares that Nigerian companies I have shares in. So I couldn't remember the date very well. I just know that most of them, I bought them 2018. Some I bought before 2018. I just put the dummy date of 2018 and say, you know what, I'm going to start tracking from that point onwards. Actually, I also used my transaction history too on Meristem. But the problem was that I would buy some on a particular day, I'll buy some on a different month. So I said, well, you know what, I'm just going to assume everything I bought them at the 1st of January 2018. Then I put the buy price. So this one, I got them easily from my broker. So my Meristem always shows me the cost price of my shares. You know, they even add up the transaction cost. So when they add up the brokerage fee, the SEC fees, so what was the actual amount it cost me, you know? And then, as I've told you before, you know, I have a formula in here that computes the current price. So that way, every day, you know, I'm seeing what I bought the shares at versus what they are currently selling at. So you see, one thing has been amazing, you know, Airtel, when I bought it, it was going down. You know, you see this 329 Naira. 2 months after I bought it, it was 290 something. The reason I bought it was I know that the telecoms are going to benefit this period. There's just going to be an uptrend for them. They are not facing the kind of problem manufacturers are facing, where they have to import at expenses, at dollars, and difficult to pass the cost to us. They are not facing, most of their costs are already sunk. It's operational expenses, and which is very small. You know, the dollar-based operational expenses of their is very small fraction of the entire expenses. So I know that for them, you know, people are using the internet a lot more during this period. People are browsing more on their phones and making more phone calls, working from home. So all those convictions were so strong that even when it was going down, I never sold. So I bought very small anyway. But I didn't sell. But what I did was I thought MTN would gain more. So what I did was I bought more of MTN. So let's go check. So you notice in MTN, I bought a lot more on MTN. So, but unfortunately, the Airtel one rose a lot more. The MTN has risen too, but you know, I never imagined that the Airtel will rise that much. But again, I'm just trying to let you know that this thing is automated. I set it up once, and all I just do is on my phone. It's just that I can't show you my phone screen right now because of the internet problem. I just, you know, Google Sheets is on phone, right? If you have an Android phone, and I think it will be there also too on Apple phone, you will just instantly see. Let me try to see if I can show you my phone screen. Let's see. So if I turn on my video, let's see. So on my phone, there is Google Sheets. Let's see. So there's Google Sheets, you see? Let's see if that is visible enough. You can see that there is a Google Sheet is where now. Yeah, Google Sheet is that one beside Telegram, right? So once I punch it, you know, I'm able to open it on my phone, and I just the very same investment portfolio that I'm able to see on the computer. So this makes life easy. It becomes like a phone app. So, you know, I'm on the move. I just open this and I see, oh, what has happened to my entire investment portfolio stuff, and I see everything. And then, you know, I just check it maybe once or twice a week and I move on with my life, you know. So that's what most people want. They don't want something that they have to be the one updating it every single day, you know. So that's what this makes possible. Let me go back here. And, okay, so I have to start rounding up. Any questions? So I'm just trying to let you understand that, you know, all these are already there. You can take advantage of that template. And then one other thing that I wanted you to be aware of is, let me just go open it. So it was one of the files I sent to myself. Unfortunately, maybe I will have to do this on a different session. You know, it's like time is up. So I just wanted to just point it out that also another thing I use Excel for is analysis. I see a lot of people take loans. You know, it could be maybe your company has partnered with a particular bank, maybe Access Bank or First Bank, and they're saying, you know what, the bank is going to offer all employees of XYZ company where you work, you know, salary loans or loans that to fund your car, you know, buy a car loan, buy a phone loan. They tell you mostly, they just tell you that you'll pay back over and, you know, buy this car that is 9 million naira. You're going to be paying maybe 400,000 naira every month for the next 5 years. Most people don't understand that all these things, you know, what if, how do you compare it with that option? Because they don't tell you the interest rates. They just tell you, they tell you what the car is worth if you pay instantly, and what, you know, if you don't want to pay instantly, then what you'll be paying per month. That's the same thing too with real estate. You know, so they just tell you, oh, if you buy instantly, you pay, you know, 15 million. But if you're going to pay instantly, we're talking maybe 9,000 naira, you know, every month for the next 12 or 17 months. So most people don't know how to compare. Am I getting this at a 10% interest, you know, rate, or at a 20%? So I excel for that. So on a different day, I'll walk you through how I do that, you know, how you can take, you know, you want to take a all these microfinance loan or salary loans where they don't tell you the rate, or maybe they tell you it's between 2% to 4% a month, but they don't actually tell you the very rate they're using for you. You know what they just tell you is how much you're going to be deducting, and these are the fixed fees you pay ahead. And then you, how do you compare, you know, how do you compare this with other options you could have, you know, gotten, you know, how do you compare even, you know, multiple types? So how do you extract out the actual interest rate? How then do you also, there's some other times too, you want to take a loan and you want to play with the numbers in your head, you know, will this thing make sense or not, you know? So I use Excel for those kind of things. Even I'm a very loan adverse person, and I'm a small, I don't have big ambitions like that. So I use it a lot for people, other, you know, they have this idea, they are trying to set up a business, they are trying to go into something. So I help them to get clarity, at least from the number side. They can go and think about it, if it is achievable or not, but at least they see black and white that this is how the numbers will play out. So if you are those kind of ambitious persons or people who have all these ideas in their head about, you know, things that they want to do business-wise, those are other things I use Excel for. And again, some people, it's personal. You want to go take a very expensive start, some very expensive schools, maybe even Harvard, and you want to just play out the numbers, you know, in your head, you know, okay, this is how much it's going to cost me in terms of lost income, and then all of that, then I'm going to take a loan too, and then also the potential income that will come. You just want to see. You want to see, instead of you overthinking things, you want to just lay them out in a template in Excel and see how everything plays out, right? Okay, the real estate one is really easy. It's just for you to just write the property, the day you bought, the price. The current price is just tricky. You just have to maybe call the real estate company to find it out. So that's the only one that I could not automate, because there's nowhere in Nigeria for you to go and grab real estate live prices. And so we have come to the end. Apologies for the glitches that happened during the earlier part of the session, even almost till the middle of the session. It's internet. I'm in a hotel today. And I was actually expecting that the hotel internet would be shitty, you know, would not be great. But I wasn't expecting that my MTN and Airtel were going to also be not good at all too. So any questions? So any questions from what I've said? At least I've tried, I've covered three out of four things that I was thinking I would cover. You know, I've shown you how personally I use Excel to track my personal finances, investment in specific terms now, not expenses. And then I've shown you, I've given you a template that you can use, right? If you check the chat box, the template is there. So it's the same template that I have customized to my own investment. So you can customize it to yours, right? And then I told you about the app that allows you to be able to grab inflation rate, exchange rate, even company. If I'm interested in a particular company, so I want to see for Dang Cement, or let's even say I want to see for Access Bank. You know, I want to see their performance. So if I want to see for Access Bank, you know, all the financial performance for this particular company. Once I just click on this company name and I come here and I click on the on. That this is the company again. I'm sure it's to come up. It's to bring up everything about Access Bank. Yeah, I mean all their financials. It's going to come up. You can try it. I guess my internet is trying to do me some disturbance today. So any questions I need to wrap up in the next 2 to 3 minutes? Any questions, any comments from anybody? Anything anybody has something they want to maybe like an addition or another perspective to something I've said that I can see is telling me his connection is trying to be restored, blah, blah. So any questions? Are we good to sign off at this point? Has it been an exciting session today? Have you found this session valuable? Okay, and I'll have to wrap up and end the session then. But can we all maybe just type, you know, did we find it useful? Is there anything you wish that elaborated more on? Thank you, Mr. Moses, for the questions that brought in some valuable clarity and some other aspects to the presentation today.